and mentioned among the strikeout leaders of all time. You look at the impressive names and what 3,000 does for any pitcher. He's been around nearly two decades, a career that has covered everything from a World Series title to a Cy Young Award, and he's been outstanding for different teams, not just the Yankees. We remember what he did with the Milwaukee Brewers. Mm-hmm. You're a Hall of Famer. You have a Hall of Fame vote. You heard the broadcast. Any doubt in your mind that he is a Hall of Famer?
I think so. I mean, I faced CC his first 7 years a lot in Central Division with Chicago and Cleveland. He was a special pitcher. You know, back then he threw 97, big curveball, good changeup, but he was a battler, and he always pitched deep in the ball games. He gave you 7 2/3 almost every night, eight innings. Definitely for me, he's a Hall of Famer.
Frank, he's going to have my vote. No question about it for me. You look at this century, since the turn of the century, most innings, most strikeouts, most wins. I always look at it, Frank, and say, and consider your Hall of Fame classmates, is this player essential to telling the story of his generation? And again, in this century, there's been no one who has done the bulk of the work and really the quality of the work, I think, enduringly, than CC. The ERA is maybe a bit higher than you would like, mm-hmm. but consider the context.
Yes.
New York Yankees, American League East for a decade, and then, of course, even before then, Jacobs Field in those days, the ball was hopping there as well. So consider all of that. It's a Hall of Famer, and I found it really interesting. His debut, 2001, back at the age of 20, in that game, he faced Cal Ripken Jr.
Right.
And the infield behind him, Omar Vizquel, Roberto Alomar, Jim Thome. Lots of Cooperstown there.
You would say the steroid era. I mean, his numbers.
Yes, he did. He dominated in the steroid era. Like I said, I was 4-for-22 against CC, and I was in his prime, so I dominated left-handers. And he was a tough customer.
And in 08 with Milwaukee, there was a 17-game stretch where he had seven complete games, almost carried that team on his back. So we'll continue to take a look at what he has accomplished. And when you look at the current pitchers who have started in the most games that are active, Sabathia, we have Greinke tonight, and Felix Hernandez, Cole Hamels active tonight, Justin Verlander outstanding with the Astros. Of this group, the only one not on the mound. So let's check in. Frank, which of those three early here as we wrap up April, the biggest surprise so far?
For me, it's Seattle. No doubt it's Seattle. They tore this team apart this offseason, and they rebuilt. But they did get Jay Bruce, and they got Encarnacion, two middle of the lineup guys, and they just filled in around those guys, and they did a great job. Obviously, they got great chemistry because to jump out and play the way they played over the month of April, no one saw this coming. 18 wins in April, I really thought this team would be at the bottom of the Western Division.
They're almost getting back to those great vintage Mariner teams of Edgar and A-Rod and Griffey and Buehner with all the home runs. And to me, it's also Domingo Santana coming in there. He was really overlooked by Milwaukee, I thought, last year. He's a 30-homer guy. Mm-hmm. And it was interesting to hear Jerry Dipoto talk about this, that having that trip to Japan to begin the season really helped this team forge a new identity. So many new faces mm-hmm. helped them bond together, and the results have been speaking for themselves.
Quickly, which of those three has the best chance to succeed this year?
I think Tampa Bay. Tampa's going to the playoffs for me. I know that that's a tough division, and maybe Boston still has some run to get back in this race, but to me, the consistency of that rotation, Glass now pitching so well, Snell, of course, is now back off the injured list. Tampa Bay, to me, the most flexible roster we have seen in the American
League. I agree with you. Tampa Bay is here to stay. They won 90 games last year. They've gotten better. It's been a lot of money for them, for Morton. I think they're going to be in this race either to win it or be in the playoffs.